to Your Chance. Your Chance is a place to be because we give you guys a chance to call in and speak and talk about whatever it is that you know, that would be good for you to speak about. So on my left, we have Tasha, Terry,
Trina.
And I just want to say that we are a family. We are a family. Usually be five of us up here, and we are a different age group, so that if one don't understand something, it helps us to, you know, for, like, the other two to make it sound right if I don't understand what they're speaking about. You know how young people are.
Yes. Everybody got their own views.
Yeah, so,
First, happy Cinco de Mayo to everybody who's celebrating.
To those who know what it is, because I define what it was today.
Yeah, but it's just mainly if you are going out to drink, please be safe. Please do not drink and drive. Please be safe.
And that's good that we are involving ourselves into the Mexican culture. Yeah. I think that's pretty cool, you know. I know the kids at the daycare, they had a Mexican party. You know, they had the hat, the mustache, the poncho, and they was like, I wish I knew that song, but it was like a rocking song, and it was jamming. So they bring it in school, in preschool, you know. So I guess we'd be looking forward to it. Are y'all planning on buying some Mexican outfits?
For the outfits?
No. I'm not showing the hats.
No. No. Just buy them.
Okay, we'll buy you.
I'm just trying to
buy alcohol. We can do that anytime.
You think you can buy for me every day?
Okay. On that note, you know, I was there something that you wanted to say about that?
Nope. Happy Cinco de Mayo, y'all safe.
Oh.
Yes. Yeah. Be safe.
And what I wanted to talk about is that the things that people do, you know, because there's a lot of things that a lot of people want to, you know, change their life. They want to make it to heaven, and they don't know how to go by doing it. But first, you have to cleanse yourself, and you have to die from your sins. And your sins, you know, are the things that you do. That's why I say the things that people do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and what are some of the things that people do that they shouldn't do?
Cheat.
Okay, like, say
kill, steal, talk about others.
Oh, yeah, especially talking about others. Because, you know, if you talk judging. About, you know, you judge and you're talking about others, I mean, you know, what good could come out of it for you, you know? So that's one right there. You got to die. Leave that alone. Like, try something new. Get away from all of that. I mean, it's time to make a big, big change, you know. We got to make a difference in this world because it's about to come to an end, you know. And a lot of people think it's not. It is. It's about to come to an end. And so I just want to help you a little bit, you know. Like if you have a wife and you can't get along, but you go out here and find that you could talk to somebody else, and they say, oh, yeah, you know, I like you, and I like you. I used to talk to my wife like that. You could still talk to your wife like that. You know, you just got to let that past leave. You know, just forget about all the bad things that happened. That's the problem right there, too. We stay on bad stuff. Let's stay on some good stuff. Everybody talk positive, and let's think about the good times and the good things we do. Nobody wants to keep humping on that. Then they want to go and find another woman, which, okay, you find another woman, but you treat her good. Now you're coming home treating your wife even worse. Okay, now if you get back with your wife and you treat her like you treat that new woman, you'll have a happy life, you know, happy marriage, happy life, you know. And then there's another sin out here. I mean, you know, it's all right to help other people with their kids, but take care of your own family first. You know, men and women, go back home. And some of y'all don't even know y'all own kids. You know, I mean, you wait till they grow up, and then you want to say, somebody kept me out of their life. You kept me out of their life. But yet, you raising somebody else's kid, and that person, this is the killing part about it. the father is actually raising their kids, and this kid got two fathers when somebody else don't have no father out there. I mean, so that's a sin. So, I mean, until you change your ways and die from that, things would change, you know? So I'm trying to tell you, you know, you gotta fight. You like in a rubber band that keep, you're trying to get out, but it's bouncing right back in. You gotta stop it, you know? We want to cut through that, and we don't want to ever let it close back up, you know? And what we need in this world now is just true love, a lot of love. I'm telling you, we gotta have that. You know, you go to work. You can treat everybody so goddamn good at, on a job, you know? Oh, you a happy sucker, you know? Then you want to come home, and then you want to walk through that door, and everything that didn't happen to you good on that job, you bring it home to your family, and you want to cuss them out. You want to start complaining about all the dishes and say, where my food at? And blah, blah, blah. You make it hard for yourself.
You do.
So we need to be truthful around here, you know? And that's the part right there. Don't nobody never want to be truthful. And everybody's so interested in all these lies. Do you know a liar is a storyteller? A real liar is a storyteller. They will lie you out of your drawers, and you sitting up here and you letting them do it. If you don't see it with your own eyes, don't believe it, you know? Don't believe it. That's a sin right there, because, you know, you letting people just take over you, you know. It's a nice day outside. It's summertime. A lot of people out there, and they enjoy life. But you know what? Is they really enjoying life, or is life going to take over them, you know? Because, I mean, it's people out here that you don't know what their agenda is, you know. There's a lot of people out here that, you know, you got these young kids that coming up with these fancy cars. And, I mean, some of these older people is like, well, God, how did they get that car at a young age? You know, you got a lot of envy people out here, and they will set you up in a minute, you know? Jealous, hateful. I mean, you know, because they already think their life is doomed, and they don't know their life is not doomed. You can have it, too. If you start loving on what somebody else got, you can have it, and you can be, hey, all of that could come to you, too. I don't hate on people. That's my main thing. I try to do not hate on people. And then you pray for your enemies. You put them in your hand. If somebody done did something to you, like spoke bad words or trying to hurt you, even put their hands on you, I ain't lying. I swear, give it to the Lord. Give it to the Lord. He going to handle it. He going to take it. He going to not only take it, but he going to solve your problems where that when he solved that problem, what's going to happen is that he's going to take care of your enemy too, you know? And if you just change your ways and try something, why keep trying the same old thing that ain't working for you? Change your ways, change it, you know? I'm like crying out to you, because that's the only way we're going to get love back. This world is getting so goddamn bad. People is shooting people and hurting people for no reason over a stupid word, you know? And it's crazy. So, I mean, you know, there's a lot of people. I'm hoping that a lot of young people is listening. Right, you guys?
Mm-hmm. We get to talk now?
I'm sorry, because I can talk a lot.
You just switched from four different subjects, and I was trying to chime in on all of them. Before I can get my words out, you just switched to something else. And it was just, okay, she just gone. So I'll be like, hold up, can we go back to this, and stop you guys, I'm going to let you talk. I'm going to let you go ahead and get it out.
I was just giving everybody kind of like an idea of what's going on in my mind, because it's a lot. But go ahead, I'm sorry.
I know me.
I'm going to talk. You got to just interrupt me, you know?
Yeah, but about the, you said, like you said, when people go to work, and they be happy with people at work, and you come home, and it's pretty much the thing, because you're not happy at work, really. You're not really happy at work. When you go to work, you put on a face. Everybody knows. When you go to work, you put on a face. It's people you don't want to talk to, but you talk to them to be cordial.
Or sometimes it is I went to get away from the house.
See, sometimes it depends on what you do. Because what I do, I work in a plant. Well,
I'm not friendly, so I go to work. I hate work. But when I come home, home is like an outlet to me. But see, then it's people like her. She love work.
Because I don't do nothing.
See, she go to work. And she come back happy.
Yeah. You know? Mm-hmm. But you have had a job where you went to work and you came back always brought to your man.
Well, she yeah, I
did. So, so you have both sides, you know, the difference. So, you know, just because you have a bad day at work or a bad job, that don't mean that,
take it out when you get home.
Right. And then, you know, and then it just shows you that you can make a change in that, too, because the if you constantly hopping on how bad you feel on a job, it's going to get worse. Yeah. You got to keep saying, oh, it's going to get better, and I'm going to make this work, you know?
Because if I'm not happy somewhere, I'm not going to stay there. I don't care how much money the job pays. I'm not happy. I'm not about to sit up here and make my life miserable for some money. It's not. Money is not always everything, especially when it comes down to your health and stuff. Because, I mean... You can't enjoy money if you're not happy.
Well, right now. Get it.
Two kids.
Y'all ain't going nowhere no time soon.
Like, I had to change mine, so now, like, I'm happy. At first, I was like, dang, I was looking at the money, but then, like, it's a totally different change now that I'm back to where I want to be. What I want to do. So,
like she said, don't stay in the job just because the money and everything, because money isn't everything.
Right. And on top of that, you found a better position, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, than you had before and paying more. And sometimes it's a key to get out of it. Leave and find something else, you know?
All of them signs, when it's time to go, it's time to go.
Right. Don't just leave off your job right away. You know, find you another one before you leave, you know? Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you gotta leave, because if you don't leave, then you're gonna stay forever.
Yeah, and then, yeah, because you can only go and look for a minute. You can't go and look like you want to look if you're still working.
Yeah, also about the man, yeah, it's not even so much as the men now either, because, like, the men will, you know, they do tend to shy away from their kids from different relationships, like, and when they get into a relationship with somebody else, they do take care of that whole household, and then it's kind of like, okay, well, what about your other kids? You know, are you going to take care of them? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it's just blessed. So I get what you're saying about that. Like, you do need to take care of all your kids, not just mine. And if you're taking care of somebody else's kid, you definitely should make it a priority to take care of yours.
Mm-hmm. It's like, if you are not seeing your blood child every day, and you at home with your girlfriend's kids, like, they don't
nothing
triggers, like, oh, let me go call my kids.
Yeah, and even my kids. You know, like,
I just don't understand how that process goes.
I don't understand where their mind is at. I mean, it's just hard to figure out, you know, how do a man think like that? I mean, I know all men ain't like that, but, wow, it's just deep, you know. And,
that's
a lot.
Gotta pray for them all.
But that's what I want them to do. They need to pray because they can enjoy their kids and somebody else's kid. And then when your kid do go over there and they taking care of somebody else's kid, and then their kid do go visit, they still don't really get the same great attention that, you know, that child is living in the house with.
So now, but they get the attention that everybody else get, and then you get the same thing everybody else, you're not getting your one-on-one time, you're not, you know what I'm saying? So, basically, mm-hmm. You're still missing out. You know, you get the visits, but
that's where they should, like, sometimes it should be, like, a day, like, if you get the other child, if you get your child to come and visit, it should be, like, a day with just y'all. It don't have to be the whole weekend, it could be a day, just as long as it's a day amongst y'all two, or y'all, whatever, how many other kids you got.
Well, you know, and then you think your life is so good, but it seems good at that time. But then when that woman leave you and leave you with her kids, gone,
you are alone. And then what? You gonna reach out to your 18-year-old, 20-some-year-old, 10-year-old? I'm back. That's crazy. You know, but, you know, that's when all hell's gonna break out, you know.
I just pray that stuff like that get better. Because, you know, I never, you know what I'm saying? Like, kids, because kids grow up and they, you know what I'm saying, they feel like they've been neglected by stuff like that. And that affects them in the long run, you know.
So sometimes it triggers, like, how the kids act today.
Yeah.
And they do, like, people don't understand the household, like, certain situations affect the kids. So it makes them act a certain way because, well, my daddy not here, my mama not around, you know. Like, all they act out because for a reason. It's never just because. It's always a reason why the kids act out.
Right. And then, too, like, you know, if you want a better life, too, I want to, you know, tell you, like, if you ain't got Jesus in your life or if you don't know nothing about Jesus, regardless, still try to turn your life around. Like, you know, you want to stay away from people that so-called friends who think they're going to be there for you and try to, you know, they're your friend for a minute and then next thing you know they're leading you into something that's going to get you in trouble and put you in jail or hurt you or get you hurt for trying to help them in dealing with something, you know. And then, you know, or give you, tell you about an opportunity somewhere that could harm you or hurt you. You know, you got to be aware of all them things and stuff, you know. And then, you know, opportunities, hate, all of that. You got to be aware of your surroundings and everything. Like, you know, it's hard out here, you know. People out here, you know, asking for a dollar. That's how hard it is. And nobody wants to give them a penny. Not even change. But you know what? You know what the killing part that upset me is when I'm driving and these people don't have patience in the cars, you know?
People ain't got patience. I'm
going from give a chance to be a patient.
Somebody on the street to somebody in a car.
I was just thinking about the woman. You know, let me tell you how crazy and strange things are. Yesterday, me and my husband, we was driving, and we was driving down 7 miles. So the light caught us, but when the light turned green, and then we was turning left, so we was in a left-hand turn, and there was a truck in front of us. So the lady, the cars that went past, she out in the middle of the street. Now, she could turn, but she just sitting there. So we like, what's going on? She trying to wait until she could turn and let us sit and wait on the light again. So what happened is that she sat so goddamn long, the light turned red on her. So I told my husband, I said, bag up, so the woman could bag up and get, you know, out the way from the cars going this way. Because we trying to turn left. Oh, my God. This woman, she did not back up. I said, there's something wrong with her. There's something wrong with her. So the light turned green again. And cars going by. I said, she better turn this time. So this woman did not turn. She's still sitting at the light. We like, oh, my God. Now it's about to turn red again. So my husband went to, because when my car's coming, so he went to get ready and turn. And when he went to get ready and turn, that woman hurry up and turn too. We turning at the same time. And she was spitting all out the window. She was calling us MF and everything. And I said, boy, some crazy people out here in this world, you know. But she just literally just sat there and two lights, green lights came up and she would not move. So this is what I'm talking about, the weird stuff that people do, you know. You need to repent. That woman need to repent herself. I just saw a demon just like, she was just spitting. Your mother, your age. And she was doing she was I was like, oh, my God. And see, that just shows me that, you know, people don't have patience. And y'all, forgive me, you know, I will turn and get off the subject in a minute and jump to something else. So I'm sorry, but we can always go back to that subject, you know.
Yeah, those two people, and crazy people too, you gotta watch out for, because now you know people getting shot.
Yeah.
Road rage. For you honking hard at somebody who's doing something wrong, you get in trouble. You know, my mom, so you do a lot of tend to be careful too with those, like her yelling at y'all and she in the wrong. Right. Or you ain't been trying. It is.
Right. And then she wound up still getting in front of us, right? So I said, oh, Lord, she gonna slow up on us. But she kind of speed rolled up a little more. So whoever was in the car with her probably told her, you know, she don't know who we are or whatever. But she went her way. You know, if we had got in front of her, trust me, I wouldn't have been running to my house.
Yeah.
I wasn't scared either because the Lord, you know, is my protector. Yeah. So, how everybody going to spend their summer?
Work.
Got two kids.
Y'all sound so old now.
We usually go on a girls trip every year, but this year it was kind of like love, work, and because basically we're trying to get a house, trying to be a homeowner, so responsibilities first.
Well, yeah, all that. I got a little baby now, so we trying to figure it out, because moving with two of them is hard now. I don't know how y'all people with 4, 5, 6, I don't know how y'all do it, because I'm struggling with two.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that could handle like 5 and 6 kids at one time.
God bless y'all heart.
We have triplets, you know.
Bless y'all heart. But God gives those children who he know can handle.
Right. Kids, like, I don't know what they call that, quadruple, I don't know the name for it, but.
God gave me what I can handle because I'm losing my mind.
I'm trying to live like mom and daddy and my older sister.
How's that? Oh, free?
Yeah.
You should have space on. You
got
a good ways to go.
No, she has good ways to go. No, she
So getting back, I just want everybody that got cars out here, please be mindful for the people who walking across the street. And there was this old man, he was crippled. He was like walking across the street and he had a bad limp. You know people was actually about to run him over.
Not that situation, I'm understanding. But you have those that's just plain ignorant and just want to mosey on across, like, in cars trying. You know, cars ain't trying to turn and this and that and that. Like,
regardless, you still in a car driving. Let them do what they're going to do.
But if you don't, like, y'all do that on purpose.
Y'all let them do cross the street cricket when you cross the street.
Right, like, you cross the street.
It takes more time for you to cross the cricket.
Yeah, that
if
is true.
Go across, you get there. Really, dang.
But this man was, he was crossing right at the light like he's supposed to. But I know what you're saying, because when they cross over, you know, right. I mean, some people just got.
You have those that's just ignorant. And it's just like, really?
And you got some people that mess it up for other folks. And that's for everything. Certain people mess it up for other folks.
Yeah.
And that's just how it really goes. So sometimes, it's just like a homeless person. You give a homeless person money because you feel like they need it. And then you give somebody else money. That person is just playing on your emotions. They don't even need it. They mess it up for other people.
Right.
So you got people that cross the street and they mess it up for other people who really should be considerate for across the street. I mean, you can tell who.
Because who is that little man that always be on 7 Mile? I brought him a breakfast and, I brought him breakfast.
With the old shirt, the kind of like the big
guy. Be hanging on it. Yeah, he be hanging on it.
With the
bed. Oh, they saw him walking without the
shirt. Yeah, you saw him. I was driving. I think I just dropped the kids off at school, and he was coming to stand in his usual spot. But I can't remember what it was. I don't know if it started raining or something. But he was walking, and as he was walking, I'm like, okay, he walking. I look again. He didn't pick the crutches up, and he was running. I was like, oh, hey, man, what's wrong with you? I mean, he was running full speed to get to his corner. I don't know who he was running for, but he was running. Then he got to the corner. And I'm just like, so it's not even wrong with you. You just sit here. You use the crutches as just so you won't get tired of standing up. You know, you just lean on the crutches and you have your hand over them. And all these bags. I don't know if them bags ain't filled with paper, other bags. You filled the bags with other bags and it looked like you just got a whole bunch still hanging from your clothes. Some homeless people, like, if you pay attention to the same people who stay on the same corner, well, y'all be homeless. Y'all do have a lot of clothes. Mm-hmm. Y'all pay attention to, like, they change clothes a lot. I pay attention to everything, too.
Especially on La Ross in 94.
That's because they live in a house.
Oh, yeah. That's the street.
You come up off the freeway,
they live in a corner.
Yeah, it's like about,
they take turns.
About five of them and stuff. It's mm-hmm. like,
they go in
two brown ones and two, three Caucasian, and they take turns. They go back and forth.
They go in at the house, and they go sit on the corner in the creek.
You can reach us at 313-868-0342 or 313-868-0351 or 313-688-4336. The call numbers are up there, you know, because we're on Facebook now, you know, so people, a lot of people probably seeing us for the first time. We are called Your Chance, you know, so we give y'all a chance to call in because it's some, you know, something crazy could have happened out there that the world need to know about, you know, so you can share too if you want to, you know. Nobody knows who you are. It's just a voice. You guys can see us, so it's all good. But anyway, let me tell y'all about what I had to do. I was coming home, and the kids was getting out of school. Do you know, this little girl, she couldn't have been no more than 8 years old, and she had three little kids with her. The youngest had to have been about, like, four, and the other one, I mean, five years old, and the other one like six or seven, like that, you know. And, well, she probably was eight, but them kids was real little. Crossing the main street, she did not have their hands or nothing. I had to take my car and pull it to the side, like turn my car actually sideways. Just, you know, it was your
truck. You're so petty.
Just like what they're doing now. How do y'all feel about parents now are putting their kids in Lyfts and Ubers.
For real?
Yep.
Are they?
Five, six.
That's too much. Like, I couldn't do it.
They actually have programs for you to see your child, and I guess, like, they making it where, like, you can see their route as they're going.
I mean, I'm getting the parent
count. Yeah,
understandable and more safer than them walking, because a lot of people, you don't have other people to help. Like, you don't have no help, so you have to do whatever you have to do. They still have to get an education, so.
Okay, but some of these people here.
I mean, I'm just saying that you have to look at other people's shoes. Like, you don't know their situation.
A five-year-old, some of them could talk real, real good. Some of them can't speak real good. But the thing is that when they out there and they in that car, now, what if this person is a jailbird, just got out, or a child molester or something like that? You know, he could pull over in a minute and do something to that child real quick, and that child, how you gonna explain what happened?
It's just crazy.
I mean, they're probably doing that because they send them on a plane. When they take that plane, they send them kids on a plane. I don't think they should do that. I think they should always be with a
parent. I was listening to that on the radio station, and they were saying, like, a lot of parents are doing that now, and a lot of parents don't have the support to, you know what I'm saying, have people take their kids to school.
It's hard sometimes, and we got mom and daddy. So just imagine them, they don't have the dad, they don't have mom and daddy. Like, majority of the time, it's a one-parent household. That's why we need to, like, start the dads. Like, y'all need to start really stepping up and helping out, because you really putting your child in danger with your child not being there helping out.
Well, I bet if they put in law that if you don't help out, we'll cut your little money. I'm gonna let people start stepping up.
Lord Jesus.
I mean, the views and opinions of my mom is not the views and opinions of my
ours. But sometimes you have to put pressure on people, you know.
Women's
ought to get together and make that law, make a law like that.
Well, I'm still, I mean, they using it to make babies with, you know.
I just feel, I guess everybody won't be in a position or whatever, but I just can't put my kid in the car or let them work by themselves. I feel like they're too young, you know what I'm saying? And even though they got all this stuff now where you can watch the vehicle as it goes, where it's going and stuff like that, what happens when the vehicle goes off track and they decide to change their mind about taking your child somewhere and do something on their own?
Or a signal fail or something.
Yeah, you can't move as fast to get your child. You don't even know where your child going, because, you know, it's just like, it's not about knowing a person's identity and stuff like that. Now, they got your child, and now it's like cat and mouse. Now you got your child.
And now, Jerry's not saying that you're not saying. And then it's Uber and Lyft. Anybody off the street can be an Uber and Lyft driver.
It's not even like you employed through a company. Like, are you, like, I filled out, I am actually an Uber driver, and I'm actually a Lyft driver.
But you don't do nothing.
I don't do, because I'm scared to put you in car.
Scared.
I got both the apps. I got the Uber app and the Lyft app. I was going to do it. When I had my 200, I was going to do it. And then I was like, I started hearing stories about how the drivers started getting stabbed and stuff.
But you know how it would be dangerous for you, because when you get ready and pick somebody up, they'll give the company their name and charge card. But they might be
somebody else's
car or something, you know?
Because what was that last accident somebody...
They do. It was waiting on an Uber or something, and she got into the wrong car because she thought that it was an Uber driver, but it wasn't an Uber.
Right, but she wasn't looking because she was on her cell phone. She wound up.
I'm not gonna have it.
But see, that's what happened to a kid, because eventually a parent would get careless and they'd be like, the Uber out there, go out there and get in it. And it could be just a regular car, and the kid gonna just run out there and get in it. You know?
Okay. The Ubers don't have the signs like the Lyfts do. Because no, the Lyfts, they have the
you don't even have to put that in your car. You can put, they give you stickers, they give you that. Toronto. But I wanted to do it because I had a friend who was doing it. She was doing it on the weekends. And she was only doing downtown, though. You know, she would only pick people up from downtown, like at the parties and stuff like that. And then she'd drop them off. And then she'd just go home. You know what I'm saying? Once you get late and stuff. But I wanted to do it because it was just like, it was the hottest thing. You was making free money. What the hell is that? But I never did it, though. But I did. I filled out some books over.
You don't have to tell me you do.
Because I ain't never do it. I'm chicken. I'm sorry. I'm scared. Because you don't never know. Like you said, people can fill out stuff like that. And people can fill it out. And then you go pick them up and they don't even be them. Or even if they don't be them, it could be them. And they can be on some still devious stuff and have somebody behind them trailing them to get you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, be like, well, I ain't had nothing to do with it, but you did. Because it's like you setting up. You know what I'm saying? They know what vehicle you're driving in, what you look like, you know what I'm saying? They got to get all that information just as well as you. Yeah, you get all that information, what they look like and all that stuff too, but it's just like I said, if you're working with somebody else, you can have somebody else behind you just, well, come on, we're going to get them. You know what I'm saying?
So this is what I want to know, because like cabs, the real cabs, they have that glass, that bulletproof glass back there. So if they got a bulletproof glass back there, why do these other people who just got their regular car picking up people don't think things can happen to them? Somebody always find a loophole in something. You know, it's going to be a loophole. They're going to get strangled or something going to happen.
It did make you think, like, the cabs got the safety.
Yeah, they got all the safety and they still have all the
people. You got to call the right cabs. They're not. Individuals can own cab place. I mean, you know, people be getting called and turning around to cabs and stuff.
Yeah, because I think I said one time, I was in a cab one time and I had to get put off at another apartment because this man was seeing like he was like a rapist, like trying to hit on me and all kind of stuff and find out where I was living at. It was real scary. He was like a real scary dude, you know? The way he was.
I can't go up here because I'm a big drama freak. I don't like giving back seats. I don't know who and they might be back there doing whoops.
I think you know how to
yeah, but no, I ain't put my kids in all. I can't. I won't. I refuse. I lose my job. A lot of people can't say that, but I lose my job because I'm not putting my kids in no Uber for them to get to school or get to work. Just because, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They'll get to work. They ain't got a job.
Well, I just hope that people, you know, think about their child and because to me, they more important than grown-ups. So, you know, they are future. So, y'all need to get on board with watching out. We need to start really watching out for other people's kids. Y'all really need to. We need to go back. And if them mamas don't like it, then don't do nothing to them. Let them do something. Then call the police, and maybe their kids need to be taken from them if they don't want to straighten them out, you know. And then you can't wait until these kids get 9 years old to want to straighten them out and stuff. It's too late. They're going to kick your butt. You know, seriously. Yeah, that's the truth.
I think that is something that's, we do need to come up with something like for, like if your kid going to school, I know it's plenty of parents there, you know what I'm saying, that might live in your area that actually take their kids to school. Like, why can't you have, if you're going to pay an Uber or Lyft, why can't you get with another parent and at least pay them, you know what I'm saying, to come get your child when they're going to school, you know what I'm saying, or something like that. Like, if you got to send your child to school and they below the normal age that you know it's not safe for them to be out here, kids is really getting snatched now. And it's more about the kids and women than it is about anybody. Mm-hmm. So if you feel like you got to send your kid to school and they got to walk by themselves or you got to put them in an Uber or something like that, why can't we get, you know what I'm saying, different parents from school? Or, you know what I'm saying, talk to a teacher about talking to other parents about getting together to get these kids picked up. I'm pretty sure it's parents that don't mind that, especially if you're going to pay them. If you're going to pay an Uber or a Lyft or something like that to come pick your child up, why can't you just pay another parent?
Right.
You know, it's just, it's more, it makes more sense.
You know what I'm saying? Like they have the parents come and participate in school.
Yeah!
This should be programs set up for school. Like,
for people that can't afford to get their kids to and from school. This should be a nice program.
School should have a bus that would go and pick them
somebody that's, you know, free, that don't have nothing to do during the day and just go pick the kids up and take them and pick them up.
So much depression on them buses that actually do come pick the kids up. Well, you gotta live in a certain area.
Yeah.
It's just like, okay, some people don't live in a certain area. Some people can't do this.
Oh, it's like a cutoff.
That's just like work. I feel like people at work do it. If they carpool a lot, you know what I'm saying? If you can't get to work or something like that, they carpool with each other. And y'all go to work, right? So why is it so difficult for parents to talk to another parent, you know what I'm saying, to ensure the safety of their child?
It is so crazy because I don't know them, but you know a Lyft. You know a Lyft.
You know
a Uber. Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, your kid go to school every single day. Every single day from September to June. So it's just like, it seems like that should be logical. Like, I mean, even if we have to start, maybe we can start something for schools.
Maybe we can start
something for these schools to, like, for people who don't have transportation, get everybody together who lives in the same area. You know what I'm saying? Set up like a Cash App thing or something like that. You know, I pay you to, you know, say, come pick my child up. You know what I'm saying? Making sure that they get to school, you know? Mm-hmm. Or, you know what I'm saying? And for the parents to feel safe to make sure their kids make it to school, like send some type of text message to them, or, you know what I'm saying? Or let the school call. Yeah.
Even if you have to start off for free, like, it's not about money, it's just about the kids' safety. Like, if you start off for free,
but you know how
that's cool. Like, just
not going out my way to pick somebody up.
I see that's what's wrong with this world now. Like, you know,
that's reality.
Like, if it was your kid, you would want this.
And people don't, you know, only their neighbors know, but they don't want to tell them all this stuff.
And see, that's why it's daycare.
People don't want to pay for the daycare, that's why.
It is expensive, you
know. It is expensive. They don't want to pay for the daycare and stuff, you know.
So, all these
daycare. But, nah, I feel like it's definitely not, it's a lot of, I feel like there's no excuse for you to be okay at home. But they got all these programs that I can't get.
Free programs.
Man, that's the Matrix.
Oh, my God. Like, I wanted to get Kaden in there because this is, especially the one on Girl Street in 94. Mm-hmm. That one, it's the one I made too much money.
Yeah, so it's hard. If you can't afford that kind of stuff, you need to look into stuff like that. Like, that's the Matrix. And it's like a head start for children.
Real good.
And they go there. I think it start off, like, at 1 or I think before one. It's kind of
it's like a head start.
Yeah. So it's just like they have programs for you, for your kids to go to. You should not be at home and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? If you need a daycare, there's free daycares out here.
Mm-hmm. It really is, because I can't afford them. I mean, I can't afford them. I can't get them. Trust me, I try.
So next show, we definitely going to have to pull up those free daycare things and stuff, because it's nothing. All you do is call and see if you qualify or, you know what I'm saying, fill out the app or stuff like that.
Why did the state pay for it? The state pay for daycare, too.
I'm not going to forget. But the state pay for daycare, too.
They lost so much information. Like, you are the whole man.
They do, but at the end of the day, sometimes they don't give out to you. If you need it, if you need it, because I figured out and I know I'm not going to get it, but I still get some. You got to try for stuff like that. You ain't never too good to take the money from the state, because at the end of the day, they ain't never too proud to take your money from you. I'm still waiting on my taxes.
You silly.
Something I want to talk about because they're ripping people off.
Well, you'll remember me something.
Oh my God. Yeah, we're going to put the numbers up on the DM so that, you know, because a lot of people don't know the number to call in. But it really was I just wish I could think of it.
said don't.
They
definitely did not say
don't.
But it's okay. We're going to let you think you said that. I'm sorry. I'm trying
to think of the
mic. Oh, yeah. Y'all home insurance and stuff, y'all, you got to watch out because these people are really starting something off like where, you know, you pay your house note and you pay your insurance, you know, your house insurance. Your house insurance. Well, anyway, now they starting to, your house insurance is included with your house payment, and they supposed to pay all of that. They starting to, like, not pay your insurance, and then they want to send you a check later, so they said, oh, well, something happened, we weren't able to pay your insurance. And then they send you a check. A lot of people get that check because that check will look good. You know, it could be $1,300, it could be $1,400, $1,500, $1,600. And you sitting over there saying, oh, I got this money, I can spend it. No, you want to take that and pay your insurance with it and then make sure they continue to pay your house insurance, you know, because if you don't and you spend that money up, you're going to be behind. And then that's a new way of them trying to get your property from up under you. I mean, there's a lot of schemers out here. They doing some of everything to try to take your property, you know. Like, for instance, you know, we receive something that somebody want to buy our home, you know. Now, the house is almost paid for. It's practically paid for. Really, it's paid for. I'm gonna sit up here and I'm gonna give you my house for some goddamn $40,000 and my house is worth $100,000 and something. You gotta say, oh, yeah. No, I know, but this is what I'm saying. Some people gonna be out here so desperate for that cash money that they're gonna give up their home. When you give up your home and then you go out and spend all of that money that you done had, then you gotta go find another home and start all over again. And then, especially if you're in an area where you know that it's building back up, you know. You know,
we got a caller.
Caller, you're on the air. Welcome to your team.
Hi, lady.
Hey, hi.
This is my first time watching your show, and I still being kind of late.
Oh, that's fine.
But I am a primary work
driver. Wait, she's a flight or a late driver? Oh, okay. You know, but then I can't move forward
because united we win, divided we're losing. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like we have some slaves. We do have our own economy, believe it or not, just in Detroit. We, you know, we create our own wealth. Mm-hmm. And then the white men wouldn't be getting their fees. They wouldn't be making money off of it. Mm-hmm. So we could, in lieu of, you know, if people that do, that don't have any other choice, you know, it could be made safe because the whole community knows that person. So we're not worried about that person.
Right.
It's not strangers and people coming in that we should be fearing of.
Mm-hmm.
But, like I said, I grew up in Detroit. I moved to my husband. This was back when gas was almost $5 a gallon. And we were spending $200 a week on gas. So you know that was rent. And I can't afford to live in Detroit.
Right. Okay.
You know, but my children still live there.
Mm-hmm.
And I still got family in Detroit. So, there's so much that we can do as a black culture to help each other.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if everybody's goal is love somebody and help somebody,
mm-hmm.
if somebody wakes up with that mindset, if all of us wake up on that same hole, then my blueprint for the morning is I listen to God read it. I used to read it back in the day, but now they got the app. You can listen to it. I actually read it. You know, if everybody's on the same page and can see the enemy ahead and know how to respond, most times it's the fact that we're all different and our circumstances are different, we easily get offended.
Yeah.
Because I might not understand what people are through. And one of my biggest problems is putting my foot in my mouth, wondering, well, why she can't do that? Then you gotta go down and list of, well, her stuff is all to her. Well, my stuff is all to her. So, you know, we, black people, we have to have our problems.
Yeah.
And back in the day, because people, their status is they not gonna kill you when they birth, they not gonna ask for help. So the girl with all the weeds ain't gone. How did you ask me to take her kid to school? You know, there's been filled out on her hair. You know, because it's a image thing. I think everybody is about humility and everybody being on one accord. Because there's no way we can't fight about what they're doing to us. If we treat each other first.
Yeah, because they know how to work together. We have a problem with whoever the head person of that organization, like if we start this and they want to be on top, somebody want to come in and try to take over, so that we just all working together like the ants do. You know, they work together.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, my God. I had an ant farm growing up.
Mm-hmm.
And my son's nickname is Edgar. His name is Edmar.
So, what's your name? Anyway, I really appreciate you calling in, though, because you said this was your first time. But you see, I can feel your heart, you know, and you making a whole lot of sense. But have you had any problems with your Uber? Because you're not here in Detroit, but you're somewhere. I mean, the list. You somewhere.
No. Well, actually, the only issue I had was this was the big story. This is very funny. I don't live in Easter, but I still was on Easter. I go to our area, but when I was in Easter, the wife was out of my car. You know, and they tried to befriend me on me. That's the day. I got a $20 bill. But, you know, and they, the ride, they was going to store the gas station, and they wanted to continue my ride. I had to start the ride. Because their thing is, the $20 for an hour, they get the ride,
mm-hmm.
and they have you going everywhere.
Yeah. Okay, well,
you know,
I don't mean to cut you off, but we got to go, and I appreciate it. I hope you watch our show. You know, we, every other Sunday, so I hope you watch our show again, but we got to go now.
All right, I appreciate it.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Everybody, you have a blessed day. See you.
Cinco de Mayo. Don't drink too much.
Bye.
Did not know right from wrong. Somebody tried to preach the gospel to me. I didn't listen. I fell down on my knees. I was just a foolish person at that time. A change in my